الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، in fact the lecture today it came to my attention this morning actually to share it with you and that is the about توكل. The right to translate in English, we translate tawakkul, depend, or sometimes trust. But believe it or not, it is beyond that, beyond depend and beyond trust is tawakkul. When you put all the matters on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people, they're saying, and the Arab very famous with that. I say, oh, I do my work and I leave the rest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is wrong statement. That is an absolutely wrong statement. You say to leave the rest on Allah, that is a wrong statement. Why? Because we leave it everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We leave everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the rest. So I do my job and leave the rest. No, this is not the right statement to say. I will do my part and I leave it to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it successful or not successful. There is always wisdom. There is always wisdom behind it, my dear brothers and sisters. So التوكل هو تفويض الأمر كاملا لله سبحانه وتعالى. To leave all the matters completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Plus تعلق القلب بالله. And the heart will be attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding this matter. فبالتوكل يتحقق المطلوب ويندفع المكروه. By توكل and depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, complete depend and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I fulfill what I want. I fulfill what I want and the harm will be removed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill what I want in the right way. Maybe I don't like it. Maybe I don't like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give me, but believe it or not, only Him knows what is good for me and what is bad for me. I don't know. I think it's good. When I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, and I want it so badly, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not give it to me. But on that day, on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell me why He didn't give. If I give it to you, this is going to happen to you. Look. So, honestly, we always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask him more until the time will come. Either Allah azza wa jalla will give it to me now and that will be good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give me reward for it. That will be good. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will give me reward on the day of judgment and show me what is the result of this action or that demand, what I wanted. So always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has His plan. That's why the Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala says in the poetry, أنا أريد وأنت تريد والله يفعل ما يريد. Listen carefully to this poetry, to this statement. It is wisdom with Imam al-Shafi'i. It says, أنا أريد, I want something. وأنت تريد, and you want something else. But Allah do whatever He wants. But Allah do whatever He wants. والله يفعل ما يريد. Now, again, let me mention what is tawakkul again. Tafweed al-amr kamilan lillah. To leave all the matters completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To leave all the matters completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the heart will be attached to Him. Attached to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fabittawakkul, with the tawakkul, with the trust and depend only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I fulfill what I want. And the harm will be removed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give me what I really wish. Let's take an example, and I know I will share stories with you. I always share stories with you. But and maybe the stories you know it. But let's repeat the stories together to get some kind of wisdom behind those stories. When Al-Namrud ibn Kan'ar ibn Kush, Al-Namrud, the king of Iraq in that time, and in the time of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Al-Namrud, the king of Iraq in that time, he ordered the people to bring all the dry stick wood and to make huge fire to throw Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam in the middle of the fire. We know the story. And the fire, it was a great fire. Not that there was some Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, said, even if there's a bird flying in the top of the fire will be dropped, how huge the fire is, how big. That's why in Namrud, when he ordered his people, his soldiers, to throw Prophet Ibrahim, because they cannot even be close to the fire, they want to throw him from far distance to the middle of the fire. What happened? The angels making like emergency situation in the sky, in the heaven. Emergency situation. You know, things that happen to your beloved one, Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Prophet Jibreel alayhi salam, the boss and the leaders of the angel, he came to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and he asked Ibrahim, "Alaka haja? Do you want something?" Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was chained, tied up, and the fire in front of Ibrahim alayhi salam, a huge fire. And he knows going to be in the middle of this fire. Imagine that situation. He sees the death by his own eyes. He sees the death of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he sees that. And Jibreel came, said, "Do you want something, ya Ibrahim?" And Ibrahim alayhi salam, "Fa'amma minka fala." So from you, "I don't want anything. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil." Hasbi Allah, that means Allah is sufficient for me. Ni'mal wakil, I trust the bid only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in the angel. And imagine even the angel of wind, the angel of rain came down. They ask, "You want this wind to just make burn their houses? This is from you, I don't want anything." The rain, angel of rain came, "Let me send the rain to demolish this fire, to distinguish this fire." I say, "No, from you, I don't want anything. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil." Subhanallah. So Al-Namrud, the king, he made the order to throw Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam into the middle of the fire. Allah made the call. I know you know that. Ya naru kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. Ya nar, O fire, kuni bardan, be cold and peace. If there's cold, he will be froze and he die. But salam, bardan, wa salam, and salam, then be peace upon Ibrahim alayhi salam. There are some people, they say all the fires on the whole earth never burn anything because the characteristics of the fire to burn things. But no, the reality is only that specific fire was not burning, was not working, using the characters of the fire. It's been only Ibrahim. But anybody else other than Ibrahim will be burned inside the middle of the fire. Please. So that's why the soldier of Namrud, that king, they cannot even be closer to the fire. They throw him in the middle of the fire, but the fire was safe only upon Ibrahim alayhi salam. And imagine the robe with the tiding Prophet Ibrahim was completely burned. The clothes of Ibrahim was burned. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a cover, and that cover he will be in the Jannah with Ibrahim alayhi salam. He will be in the Jannah with Ibrahim alayhi salam. So we have to understand something very important. That fire, specific fire, only upon Ibrahim alayhi salam only. It was peace. But subhanallah, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he can tell the angel, "Please save me from this trouble." He can tell the angel of rain, send the rain of the wind, take this wind away, and that he can take Jibreel alayhi salam, save me from that. But no, it is not, it never happened, because the dua was very specific. Ya na, he said, "Hasbi Allah." He made the dua, "Hasbi Allah." Hasbiya, this means Allah is sufficient. Allah is the protector. Allah is the savior. Allah, the only one, will save me. No one else but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved him. So the same dua the Sahaba radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim after the battle of Uhud. As we know in the story, 70 of the Sahaba got killed in the battle of Uhud. It was really a disaster. Some people, please give your attention. Some people, they were considered the battle of Uhud is defeated. But no, it's not, was not defeated. We cannot consider any battle with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with them is defeat, but it's a test. Yes, it was a great test. Is absolutely yes. Because if the people of Quraysh, the pagan, defeat the Muslims, they will take in Medina. When they take in Medina, they change their religion, they change their deen. When the Prophet will be killed, but it's never happened of that. In fact, in reality, they run away. The people, the pagans of Quraysh, they run away. That was not defeat. Like some people, they always because hazima, hazima in Arabic, that means defeated. Is that true? It's not true. It's not accepted to say that. But that what happened, 70 of the Sahaba got killed. The Prophet himself was bleeding. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, he was bleeding. He was injured, his head, his body, he was injured, he was bleeding, he was sick, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The majority of the Sahaba was bleeding also, very tired. The pagans run away, and the Sahaba, they went back to Medina. The Sahaba, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they went back to Medina al-Munawwara. Then what happened? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent people, you know, he told the people of whoever fought in the battle of Uhud, let's go after them. The people of Quraysh, they start to send some news that we will come and kill you and do this and do that. But they used to say, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Alladhina qal lahum al-nas inna al-nasa qad jama'u lakum fakhshawhum. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that in Surah Al Imran, الذين قال لهم الناس, the people this is, they are gathering together. They start to send some spies to Medina, say they are gathering together, they will come back and they will try to fight you again and to kill you again. Allah Azza قال says, إن الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. That increased their iman, they increased their faith, and they said, Allah is sufficient for us. We depend and trust only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal gave the answer in the same ayah, in Surah Al Imran, فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. Subhanallah, فَانْقَلَبُوا, that defeat, that hazima, or that, I don't want to say defeated, but that calamity or that trial or hardship, they turn bini'mah, favors and bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people they fought, they remain in the battle of Uhud, they went to the area called Hamra al-Asad, area called Hamra al-Asad, and they waited for the pagans to come back to fight, but they run away. They run away, that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have the mercy and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See how important and how beautiful the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam say it, and the Sahaba say it. So when you have this kind of hardship and calamity, you say it too. See, hasbi Allah wa ni'ma al-wakeel. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah is sufficient, so we depend and trust only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we have this hardship and calamity. Musa عليه السلام, he depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all the matters of his life. Him and his brother Harun, Aaron, said they depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the matters of life. And we take the example when they run away from Egypt, when they run away, all Musa and his people, they run away from Egypt, from the Pharaoh. They showed the sea in front of them, as you know, I know you know the story. And they said, that's it. Inna lamutrakun. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, the people, inna lamutrakun. They said, we will be defeated, they will be killed. The Pharaoh will kill all of us and his soldiers. But Musa alayhi salam, he have this kind of tawakkul, trust, depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said, kalla inna ma'a ya rabbi. ربي سيهدين. Say no, Allah is with me. Allah will guide me. Allah is with me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide me. Subhanallah, the moment he just finished that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أنا أمر الله فضرب أن أضرب بعصاك البحر. Strike or strike the sea with your staff, with your stick. And he did. And imagine, they have 12 tribes. That sea, the water is homogeneous materials. Oxygen and hydrogen together is very homogeneous in any kind of water. And there is no to make the water standing straight. Very impossible. But by the will of Allah, tawakkul in Allah, depend in Allah, that water was making like roads for each tribe of the people of Musa, Prophet Moses, alayhi salam, make different tribe, and every tribe going from different direction, one direction. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Allah Azza wa Jal has saved him. And of course, the Pharaoh, as you know in the story, they follow them and they drawing because in the other side of the sea, he struck the sea again with the staff and the sea become homogeneous again. The water become homogeneous again and they drunk. And until now, the body of the Pharaoh, by the way, in Cairo, in Egypt, you can see his body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, the soldier will be removed, will be gone, except his body. Will make his body remain to be listens to the others, listens to the other leaders. Whoever come as a leader after that, look at that Pharaoh. And he used to say, I am God. Look what happened to him. But still, some leaders will never take the lessons. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. But my point here, imagine that sea by the tawakkul and depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْءٍ قَدْ تَوْضُ الْعَظِيمِ Just like a huge wall. Huge wall. And they start to walk. By the way, the water, as I said, is homogeneous. And the every tribe, like roads and roads and roads. And between the roads is just like a wall of water. But still the tribes, they used to see each other because it's water. They used to see each other to feel comfortable when they are running to the other part of the sea, to the desert of Sinai. See, that is the tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Musa alayhi salam said again, kalla, no, indeed not, impossible. Inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. Allah is with me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide me to do something. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, qal fadrib bi'asaka al-bahr. Fadrib, fadrab Musa, and he struck the sea with his staff. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Musa, please give your attention. Fawwada amrahu kulluhu lillah. Fawwada amrahu kulluhu lillah. That means he put all his matter, all his guidance on Allah, not the rest. Like some people, they say, I leave the rest to Allah. This is absolutely wrong statement to say, I leave the rest to Allah. But the right statement to say, I leave everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the people of Musa alayhi salam, they are weak. They are running away, in fact, from Egypt, running. Said to be, and they took gold and wealth with them. And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved all of them, subhanallah. Also, we take an example with that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he left Mecca, he is going to Medina. He is going to Medina, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took all his caution, worries about make a complete plan, successful plan to leave Mecca to go to Medina. And he took even different direction. But still the people of Quraysh, the pagans, they found out the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stays in a small cave. That cave, when we say cave normally, what is cave in our geological terms, is a huge road inside the mountain. Huge road inside the mountain. Like, the people that can live inside the mountain. But that cave, what the Quran described it, and a small hole is inside the mountain. Anybody can look like this down, he can see the end of the wall, the end of that cave, small cave. It's very small. If you went to Hajj and you visit those places and you see that small, it's very small. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sitting with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq inside that place. And Asma, she used to bring the food and so. So, you know, the story, of course, I know that. But the point is, you see, Allah Azza wa Jal, he's telling the people, إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ. If you don't want to give him victory, as Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that in Surah At-Tawbah, if you don't give him victory, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him victory. إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ نَصْر, that means victory. If you didn't give victory to the Prophet, you're not supporting the Prophet, Allah will support him. Allah will give him victory. إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الثَّانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا بِالْغَارِ. Say the people of the kuffar, the pagans, they try to follow him, to kill him and kill the Abu Bakr as-Siddiq with him. Say, إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الثَّانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا بِالْغَارِ. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ. He's telling his friend, I say, لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. So don't be sad, Allah is with us. Subhanallah, when they says that, don't be sad. And he told him, مَا ظَنُّكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ بِثْنَيْنِ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُمَا الْحَدِيثِ. So what do you think, يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ, two sitting there, Allah is the third. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the third. When he said, لَا تَحْزَن, don't be sad, Allah is with us. فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَيْهِ. فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ, Allah sent down his sakina, his peace, his tranquility upon Prophet Muhammad and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Sakina. Wa say Allah subhanahu wa ayyadahu bi junudin lam tarawha, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him from soldiers you didn't even see the soldiers. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at their feet. They can, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq inside the cave, they can see the feet of the pagans, the people outside the cave. Because the cave is not a real cave, it's small, a small hole in a mountain, a very small hole in a mountain, and they, because they are able to see the feet of the pagans. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Ya Rasulullah, if someone of them, he look at his feet, he will see us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smile, beautiful smile. So what do you think about two sitting here? Allah is with them. If Allah with us, no one will be against us. That's why if Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah At-Tawbah, فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَيْهِ وَأَيَّدَهُ بِجُنُودٍ لَمْ تَرَوْهَا وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا السُّفْلَى وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the word or the action of the disbeliever, the pagans, down, and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala up. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, he protect the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he protected Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. And in 13 years in Mecca, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They want to kill the Prophet, they can, they are able. But they killed some other of the Sahaba too. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is protecting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just like a few hours before he migrated to that cave, few hours when he was inside his house, all the tribes of the young people, strong people of the different tribes surrounding the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Surrounded the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But still the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opened the door, not from the window, then above the wall, no, from the main door. He opened the main door and he entered between those people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them sleep. Make them sleep, depend, trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, very beautiful hadith, قَلْ لَوْ تَوَكَّلْتُمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِ. If you depend, trust in Allah, the true trust, true depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا رَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide you, just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides the birds. In the morning, the birds flying, waking up and flying in the morning before the sunrise with a complete empty stomach. The end of the day, the birds come with a complete full stomach. Who provide the birds? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal, He is the one who provide the birds, and provide me, and provide you, and provide the baby inside the womb of the mother in one source of food, when the baby born from two sources of food. And now look at us. And still some people deny the mercy and the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some people deny even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal-iyadu billah. That is the most beautiful stories also We just remembered Eid al-Adha last month, brothers and sisters. And the story of Hajar عليه السلام and Ismail عليه السلام. A very unique story. I know you know the story, we repeat the story again. But my answer. And then we know the story, but just a reminder, just a reminder for all of us. When Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, he put his wife and his only son in the middle of nowhere, the middle of the desert, the middle of nowhere. And just to know the characteristics of the characteristics of the rocks on that area, the characteristics, alhamdulillah, the characteristics of the rocks is igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks. That means those kind of rocks, there is no way to find water. Impossible to find water in igneous rocks. Igneous rocks is a massive rocks. That means there is no holes in between to hold the water. You find the water in the sedimentary rocks, because the sedimentary rocks particles, and those particles, between the particles, you find the water. But in not in that area. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he left his wife and his only son in the middle of the igneous rocks and the metamorphic rocks. Imagine this. With some water and some dates. And he left. And he left. Not even looking at his wife and his son, because he didn't want to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. And his wife, seeing her husband leaving them with some water and some dates, and there is no human being, and there is no even animals, no birds, no nothing. You cannot even imagine this. Our criteria of thinking doesn't make sense. Our criteria of thinking doesn't make sense. But when Allah wants something, it's going to happen. We don't understand what's going on. We cannot comprehend the reality of the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, we can't. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants something, it's going to happen. I want something, you want something else. You would think it's good, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it's good or not good. She's following her husband, Ya Ibrahim, you leave us for whom here? Ya Ibrahim, you leave us for whom? And Ibrahim alayhi salam have no answer. He didn't even look at her. She hold him. To leave us for whom, Ya Ibrahim? Ibrahim alayhi salam, no answer. Leave us with some water and some dead. There is no food, there is no human being, there is no civilians, there is no people. Ibrahim, no answer. And she asked Ibrahim alayhi salam one question, and that is the tawakkul. And I know you know that, but listen, if you are in this situation, if me in this situation, if we are in this situation, what is our reaction will be? And she asked Ibrahim, Allah amaraka bidhalik, did Allah order you to do so? Now I want you just for a moment to imagine me, I'm in that situation, and my father leaving me, or my wife and my or husband leaving me, or son or daughter leaving me in the middle of nowhere. What is my reaction? I will think that person love me really or not? I will ask just to know, don't leave me, I'm not leaving. But she have the trust in tawakkul. When Ibrahim alayhi salam reply, and he said, yes. That means, yes, Allah ordered me to do so. But he replied only, na'am, yes. Of course, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he stood in Marwa area and he made the dua, yes. But still, the characteristics of feeling of a human being, we don't have this kind of tawakkul and trust yet. That's why all kind of problems on the Muslim world like this, because we don't have the complete trust in tawakkul yet. We want to reach half of this level. That level is mashallah. She is the wife of Prophet, and he is the son of Prophet, and he become Prophet after that. Yes, that is a level of very special level. But we want to reach the level of a trust in Allah, complete trust in Allah, and the heart will be attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then she told her husband, just go. Allah will never waste us or leave us alone here. And this has happened, as you know, in the story. All of us, we know in the story, but you brothers and sisters, you know, Jibreel came and struck the ground after the feet of Ismail, and the water came up. And until today, until this moment, until the day of judgment, the water will be Zamzam is coming up, and we're going to drink it from it, tasting it, drink it all the time. It will be shifa and wealthy and a complete food for us to drink from the Zamzam water until today, until this moment. Until the day of judgment, the Zamzam will be comes from where? Allah knows best. Of course, from the Jannah, as well as the hadith. But my point, and you brothers and sisters, the trust of Hajar alayhi salam, tawakkul in Hajar alayhi salam, and the tawakkul of Ibrahim to leave his only son, and the wife she give him birth, the baby, the first only son, after 89 years of old, Ibrahim alayhi salam, you have Ismail alayhi salam. And that wife, not Sarah, Hajar, give him the first son. See the criteria we're talking about? The wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're talking about, you know, I'm talking about completely the level of Iman, the level of trust, the level of depending Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we should learn in our life, my dear brothers and sisters, especially now. Especially now. And subhanAllah, of course, Allah Azza wa Jal saved Hajar alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam, and he sent very special, beautiful tribe of Jurhum from Yemen traveling to that area, and they found the water, and Ismail alayhi salam grew up among those people. And so we know the story. But the tawakkul, tafweed al-amr kulluhu lillah. Tafweed al-amr, that means you leave all the matters completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, Prophet Yunus, Jonah alayhi salam, who says here, they put him, the people of the boat, you know the story, they throw him in the ocean, in the sea, and the whale, Allah sent the whale. What is the whale? When the whale swallows something or eats something, that means he eating that things. The fish eat things. Look at, if you have a aquarium of fish, and look at the fish, throw the food to the fish, you feel the fish eating the food. And that whale is a kind of fish. He swallowed Prophet Yunus, Jonah alayhi salam, and Jonah going inside the whale. Jonah going inside the whale, but Allah Azza wa Jalla has given order to the whale not to eat or touch or harm Prophet Jonah, Yunus alayhi salam. Allah Azza wa Jalla giving this order. So Yunus alayhi salam, the only dua he used to do to say, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. This is the only dua he used to say. The angel used to hear that dua. يا ربي, we hear the dua. It sound like Jonah, Yunus عليه السلام, but we don't know from where this sound comes out. Because they saw the angel, of course, they saw the whale eating Jonah, Yunus alayhi salam. He said that, that means he's done, he's dead. This is the characters of the fish, the eating, the setting, done deal. But Allah Azza wa Jal has saved Yunus alayhi salam. Allah Azza wa Jal saying that also. فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْيَمِّ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَكَذَلِكَ فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْيَمِّ فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ, we save him from the whale, inside the whale from the ocean, because he was inside the darkness, and that the whale goes down deep ocean, and he's gone. To everybody, he's gone. But Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best, of course. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَأَنْجَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْيَمِّ, we saved him from that trouble, from that sea. مِنَ الْغَمِّ, استغفر الله, مِنَ الْغَمِّ, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, we will save anybody. We saved anybody in the situation of Yunus alayhi salam. So when we have a problem, we make this kind of dua, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين, and so on. And we know the story also of the mother of Musa alayhi salam. The mother of Musa, she's not a prophet, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when she was pregnant with Musa alayhi salam, Allah put the sakina inside the heart of that woman. She's a believer. The mother of Musa and Harun, the mother of Musa alayhi salam, she's a believer. And of course, that Pharaoh will make the order to kill all the children of Israel, the newborn male babies. Subhanallah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he saved that boy, Musa alayhi salam. And he told his mom, وَأَوْصَيْنَا أُمُّ مُوسَى. We give a reveal, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى أُمُّ مُوسَى. We reveal to أُمُّ مُوسَى, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى أُمُّ مُوسَى أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. We breastfeed him. فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي. وَأَوْحَيْنَا, we reveal to the mother of Musa, أَنْ أَرْضِعِي, feed him, breastfeed him. If you are worried about him, put him in a small box, inside the box, and let him go in the sea. Let him go on the sea. وَلَا تَخَافِي, don't be afraid. وَلَا تَحْزَنِي, and don't be sad. See the criteria. If my son or my daughter getting sick, I get sick. Few days ago, my son had a toothpick, and I was, oh, my tooth. I was really sad because I cannot do anything to him, to help him. Subhanallah. But imagine, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling that woman, the woman also with a newborn baby, she was really worried about the baby so much. But Allah so told her, put him in a box after you breastfeed him and let him go in the sea. And don't be sad and don't be afraid. See, our criteria, different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the answer to the mother of Musa. إِنَّا رَادُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. إِنَّا, we return Musa back to you. We return Musa back to you, and we're going to make him among the messengers. That is the tawakkul. Depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ala Imran also, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Allah loves those people who have tawakkul. Tawakkul, depend and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حُبَّ اللَّهَ أَغْلَى مِنْ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ. The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beautiful thing you can even imagine or predict, that is the love of Allah subhanahu. The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's our goal and our target in life. Put tawakkul in Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us, inshallah. May Allah make us among those mutawakkilin and depend only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us gain His love. Because this is the most beautiful fruit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ever give us, all of us, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم وهدانا الله وهداكم أجمعين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.